don't care. I just don't. It's just Cog's desperate tactic to get players to come back, and I'm just jaded by it all. Mainly from the fact that this game has a lot of issues. Issues that need to be addressed and taken care of, and the last thing I think it needs is a new character. Not to mention their horrible track record when it comes to these new character releases. They're just followed by a long list of nerfs. Nerfs that just take weeks or even months to implement because of how ridiculous the character is upon release. Yeah, no thanks. I'm tired of the same old song and dance. New face, same exact problem. Actually, I think I'll just stick with what really cemented my decision to stay away from this game, or else I could just rant forever, honestly. So if you want to skip that, just go to this time frame for the TLDR. I think what really killed the forced motivation I had to play this game outright was around the time when the game temporarily went from Elsword Online to Raven Online. And it didn't help that I was already on MapleStory 2 heavy, which was such a breath of fresh air.
And all the mobs, I keep losing damage.
Go back to the boss. Go back to the boss.
We're supposed to be fighting the boss, not each other.
Oh my god. Shima, handle the boss. What are you doing over there?
I can't handle the boss if you don't handle the mobs.
Overall, just an example of a better game with much better mechanics and practices. Although, when comparing things to Elsword, that's not saying much. See this plus 15? You can easily achieve this just by playing the game normally, and it wouldn't cost you a goddamn thing out of pocket. Unlike in Elsword, where even a plus 13 is practically unheard of. That could cost hundreds upon thousands just to roll what feels like an imaginary dice. There's an inherent power creep that's locked behind a freaking paywall, and that's not how a game should be. Whales be damned. But back on topic, like, remember when NA got that Raven Online patch nearly a month later? I want to say around October-ish, and her poster image was this? Like, seriously? That's what you want to advertise to your players? Well, you know full well that this game has some serious balancing issues right now? Which has been going on for months, even years, mind you. And with the inclusion of third jobs and skill mods, the game derailed even harder. With all that in mind, instead, you want to make the problem even worse? Yeah, no. No thanks. And then that patch note specifically, Raven got massively buffed, RH in particular. Fun fact, I heard the league just ended not too long ago, but Raven had the most star ranks on that final day, followed by Ara and then Chung. And then of course Ara got buffed, no surprise. Characters like Dion Jillian got buffed, who just cannot be touched once they roughly have over 200 MP, I think it is. And if they know how to skill cycle properly. And then at that point, it's just a one person game. You can just take your hand off the keys. I even remember characters like Dominator, who also needed to be looked at, and he just got buffed also. Like, problem characters that did not need buffs got buffed, while everyone else just got these lame copy-paste heavy trait changes. It's stuff like that that happens time and time again with this company when it comes to balancing. And balancing is in massive air quotes. When you think they're headed in the right direction, they always, always find a way to screw it up. All that progress, the one step forward, two step back on a constant repeat. And it stops being fun. The main reason why you would play this game becomes non-existent, and you're left with a decision of, how much do I want to put up with today? As far as PvE, there's not much to really say, to be honest. PvE has always been sort of a bore to me. There's like no real thought process behind it when running these dungeons. You just cycle a few skills in tandem until a room and or boss is dead. Fun. Not to mention the ungodly grind fest for just some title. I will say though, I'm happy they finally implemented a lot of quality of life changes. That should have been implemented years ago, mind you, but even then, coming from a player who's played the game since Season 1, these updates come far too late in the game's lifespan for me to care. Like I said, I'm just jaded. But that brings me to the TLDR. Despite having a channel and dedicated fanbase built solely from this game, the game just isn't fun. It sucks when it comes to balancing, mod skills for some characters are ridiculous or downright busted, PvE is just a button mashing snore fest. PvP is filled with laggers where coincidentally, button mashing becomes just as viable thanks to storage and delay. Like, I've had enough. However, as far as Elsor goes, unfortunately despite not having fun with the game, I can't just leave some of you hanging. And yes, I'm talking specifically about Vinesword. I have one episode left and I really don't want to leave it unfinished. Then, to top it all off, I think I'm going to do one final stream before ultimately uninstalling. Well, actually no, I have one more thing I want to do too. I think I have one last shit posted in me and I want to make it in regards to the new character. So I guess be on the lookout for that whenever I get around to doing them. Other than that, me and my friends have been playing a lot of other things. MapleStory 2 is definitely one of them. You can find us in the USE server if you want to stop by and say hi. And I will say this now, I will be playing Cursed Pell whenever it releases, but we all know that won't be for a long time, sadly. But yeah, this ride has definitely been something. But I always try to make the best of it. Always try to make the experience more fun, to have a good time despite all the salt and negativity that always floated around in this game. It's been fun, guys. Thank you.